नमस्कार, माय नेम इज हरदविंदर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मैक्रोस। मैक्रोस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन क्लास मैनी टाइम्स, बट जस्ट टू रिफ्रेश योर नॉलेज एज योर एग्जाम्स आर अप्रोचिंग और इफ यू हैव मिस द लेसन ऑन दोज डेज और यू फॉरगॉट, just to refresh your knowledge I'm just teaching the same again. What are the macros, what are the uses of macros in LibreOffice Calc, or in, you can say, in a spreadsheet? Macros are a set of commands, a set of instructions. Means it's very difficult for any non-programmer to write the commands in a sequence, so we can bind up all the commands in a single heading. Suppose I want to see, I want to print here the current time and date. What I'll write here is equal to now, and then this is showing today is a 22nd November 2021 and the time is 28 minutes past 20, means it's 24 hours clock. So it's very easy. We just need to type is equal to now and then bracket open and close, and we are getting. We don't know the set of instructions which are written behind this, the coding, which the programming which the scientist or a programmer has done behind this. We don't know, or we don't want to know also. So similarly, this is a set of commands. Sometimes we use many functions. Suppose I want to do the total, so just I click here and then press this button. We don't know what is the set of instructions they have done in the back. We are just using clicking that button and we are getting the result. So for making those set of commands, we use macros. Means we don't need to write 10-15 command lines or more than that again and again. You can bind up all those commands under a single heading. It is for saving your time and making your problem simpler. Sometimes the people don't know the coding, programming, functions. They can use functions easily to solve any problem. Suppose you can see in LibreOffice Calc, there are number of, as I have just given you example now. So similarly, just you can see is equal to month. It will give you error. Means this function is not available here. A lot of inbuilt functions are there in LibreOffice Calc, but you can build your own functions also. Suppose you see, as you are seeing on the screen, you are watching on the screen, I have taken an example for traffic management system. In traffic management system, I want that here we will enter the distance covered in kilometers and the time taken in minutes, and here we want the speed kilometer per hour. And here I want the remarks. The vehicle is a two-wheeler, suppose. The vehicle is a two-wheeler. I want to know, is that over speed or in a safe speed? For that purpose, I want to print here the remarks. So students, if you see, I'll click here speed function. There is no speed function available in this inbuilt function. So we can make a function speed. For making the work easier for the other people who are non-programmers, they don't need to think much about that. Okay, what is the formula for the speed, and what is the formula for calculating the remarks? What are these things? We can make our own functions. How to make our own functions? I'll teach you. Well, first thing, what is our target? First, our target is to find the speed in kilometer per hour. What we are getting, what we need, we are getting distance covered in kilometers and time taken in minutes. But the speed we need, kilometer per hour. Distance we are getting in kilometers, that's okay. But time we are getting in minutes, but we need it in hours. So what we need to convert the minutes into hours. And then we need to calculate the speed. That's it. Formula for the speed is distance upon time. means these are two, three things we have to do, and we can bind up all these two, three instructions, two, three commands, three command lines in a single heading called speed. How to do? How to make your own macro? Let me teach you where the macros are available. You can go in the tools menu and you can go in macro, and there are many options: record macro, run macro, edit macro. Right now we are going to organize our own macro. Here you can open any. Suppose here I want to, in this library in module 1, I want to create a new macro. Some macros are already made. What I need to do, I can click here edit, and there are some macros are already been made. Firstly, I'll create a function for calculating a speed. How to do? Just very first thing, you need to write the function, and then you need to write the name of your function, that is a speed. Then in the bracket you will pass the parameters, arguments which you need. We need two things. First is distance, and the second is time. Distance in kilometers and time in minutes. Then you will click here, and here we will calculate the time in hours. Because we are getting the time in minutes, we need to convert into hours. How to convert? I'll convert it. Time is equal to time divided by 60 minutes per hour. In 1 hour there are 60 minutes, so I am converting the time is equal to the time which we are getting divided by 60, means new timing will be in hours. If the person will enter 60 minutes, then the new time will be 1. If a person will enter 30 minutes, the new time will be 0.5, means half hour. So in this way we have converted the time from minutes to hours. So the rest, now we have the time in hours. Then we need to calculate the speed. The speed is equal to distance divided by time. Okay, very simple. And then here you will write end function. So dear students, two commands I have written. The function name is speed, and two parameters I need: the distance in kilometers and time in minutes. And I converted the time into hours, and then I calculated the speed, distance by time, and then I end the functions. Sometimes you can make the function without parameters also, if you don't want to get any parameter from the user like this, but here I want. The calculation, when the exactly result we want, then function name, these both should be the same. It's not case sensitive. Small caps can happen, but spellings should be exactly what the spelling you have written here. The exact spelling should be here. So after that, you will save it. Keep in mind, your function name is speed, and the first parameter is distance, and the second is time. So just save it. Now I'll calculate speed. So just I write here is equal to speed. I need two parameters. The first one is this one, then comma. The second one is our time. Time is here. Then I'll enter, and I'll get the speed. But here I am getting speed in kilometers per hour. Suppose I am entering minutes 60, then it will be 60 minutes, 60 kilometer per hour. 30, then it will be 120 kilometer per hour. So I think you have understood how to write this function speed. Now we will write the function for remarks. Means if the person's speed, two-wheeler speed, is more than 60 km, that is a danger zone. If the person is in speed of 40 to 60, that is a safer speed. So we will write the function for that. If the person is more than 120, that is a very much dangerous. So we will write the function for that. Here I will write the function remarks of speed. You can't leave the space between these words. So as I have written remarks of speed without any space, we need one parameter, that is a speed, and then we will write the function. If the speed the user has entered is greater than 120, then the remarks of speed should be dangerous speed. High alert. And if the speed is not 100 greater than 120, but it is greater than 60, then you can write simply over speed. Here you write else if if the value is greater than 120, then it will print high alert. If it is greater than 60, it will print over speed. But if both the conditions are false, in that case else it will print simply, this we don't need, it will print safer journey. Okay, so after that you will write here end if and then end function. The name of the function is remarks of speed. So it needs a one parameter, that is a speed. So here we can write is equal to remarks of speed, and what we need, that is a speed, and then press enter. It is showing over speed. If I write here, it will take 120, means the speed is 30 km per hour, which is safer. If I write here 60, this also safer journey. If I write here 35 over speed, if I write here, because 102 km per hour is a high speed. If I write here 30, then over speed. If I write here 70, then also a safer journey, because 51 km per hour. So in this way we can write a set of commands in a single heading. Here in a single heading we have used speed, and here we have used remarks of speed. This is a simple way I have taught you how can we write the macros. We can record the macros also, means we can apply the formulas here. The set of instructions will automatically be recorded at the back end. You don't need to write the coding manually in that case. In that case you can use the option like here, tools and macros, and record macro, that you can try yourself. So for writing your macros, for writing the coding by your hands, you can do this. So simply for the MCQ purpose, the questions may come. Macros, you can see the application based questions. They will give you a scenario, so you have to find out which option can be applied. So by learning, by just reading that question, you can understand macros can be applied here. Means our set of commands we want to write in a single heading, which option we can use, macro, solver, OSIC, like this. So you can sense there, or they can ask in which menu the macros option is there. You can say that is in a tools menu, and which further menus you see in the macros, record macro, run macro, edit macro, organize macro. So these are, you can write the answers in this way. So simply you have understood what is the use of macros, I think, I suppose. Thank you. Thank you very much.